from a cup of tea. From childhood, I always believed that there is something magical about this cup of goodness, this cup of happiness. Because when boiling water is poured over tea, tea imparts its distinct color, taste, and flavor, thereby changing the water forever. How many of you went to school? Show of hands. Great! You're a wonderful audience. But before I talk to you about school, let me tell you a little bit about my childhood. I grew up in the tea gardens of West Bengal. My father was a tea planter, which meant he converted the lovely, lush green tea leaves into the black tea powder that's available in the market. And as a child, I remember going to the factory to see Dad. Dad was my Superman. And I was his loyal sidekick. Minion, maybe? So every day I would go and visit him, and he would take freshly made tea, put it in my hand, and close my tiny fist, and hold his fist over mine. And while we waited, he would tell me stories. Stories that were amusing. Stories that were entertaining. Stories that were educational. And after about 5 to 7 minutes, when he would open my palm and shake off those tea leaves, I would see a lovely orange coloration on my palm. Magic, he would call it. Tea leaves its mark wherever it is. Superheroes don't wear capes. Some of them don't mind it, but if I were to hold a star in my hand for every time he made my day, I would have the whole galaxy in my hand. Off I went to school, and for those of you who went to school, the entire audience here, you would relate to this, that I was in Westminster, London, and one day the matron walked up to me and she said, "From now on, you don't need to live in the dormitory. You can share my flat. I have a room and a bath. You can have it. It's extra." On one hand, it was a moment of pride. And on the other hand, it was a moment of extreme fright. Pride? Because I did not have to share a dorm with 15 other girls now. I was selected amongst 16 girls to be her roommate. And fright, because I was living with a matron. She would know what pranks I did during the day, and I would be questioned every night. And on the first day, she walked up to me and she said, "Would you like to have a cup of tea? It's a tad traditional," she said. Okay. So she brought some lovely blackberry tea. She switched her kettle on, took a teapot, put a few spoons of blackberry tea into it, took a couple of cups, added 2 dollops of honey, waited patiently while the tea brewed. After about 5 minutes, she took that kettle and poured it into the cups. A light stir, and she gave me the tea to drink. And while we sipped our teas, we talked about how my day went, what the difference in cultures between India and UK were, how I was doing in my classes, how the teachers were, how the classes were, everything under the sun. It became a ritual for us. I came back to India, but my love for tea had grown. I remember before leaving for college, I went up to my mom one day and I said, "Mom, from now on, you don't have to waste time making tea. Here are instant tea sachets. Put it into the cup, put water, and it's done." And my mom looked at me and she said, "Sweetheart, it's not about the time you save, but about the time you spend together that makes a difference." I had learned my first most important lesson: patience. It's the time you spend together that makes The last time I did this routine, I was sitting amongst a crowd of dentists and I said, how many of you went to college? No hand came up. I said, how many of you went to school? No hand came up. And I said, how many of you were kids once? Three hands went up. The others were probably gone that way. I wasn't, so off I went to college. And in college, during my internship, we had an inter-college fest. The biggest event of Bangalore. Renaissance. And we had a debate competition. I was representing my college. 23 other colleges were participating. And the topic had been announced. The tension was growing. We had to win it. So I went to my teacher, called Dr. Vibha Shetty. Dr. Vibha Shetty was known for her style, her poise, and her articulate words. And I went up to her and I said, ma'am, we have this debate tomorrow, and I'm representing our college, and it'd be nice if I win. Would you help me, please? Can you give me some points? And she said, sure, let's discuss this over a cup of tea. Yes! The first lesson I remembered at that time. It's about the time we spent together. So we went to her cabin, she opened her flask of tea, she poured it into two plastic cups and gave me one. And she talked about what my hobbies were, what my interests were, what I planned to do after college, everything except the speech. And as she took the last sip, and I saw it draining, she said, of course I can give you points for your debate, but then it will be my debate. Wait a minute, did she just insult me? I said, okay, thank you, ma'am, I'll manage. So off I went, and I said, okay, I am going to win this debate. I need something original, something different that can get me extra points. So I went to Superman. Dad. And I said, Dad, can you give me some points for my speech? And he said, no. And I said, but Dad, I have nothing different to say. He said, really? There are 44 different chemical compounds in your body that are so unique that can help scientists identify you as a person, and it can also help crime investigators find the cause of death. Did my dad just turn into Sherlock Holmes from Superman? And I didn't even know Dr. Watson. In short, no. Okay, so I went back home and I said, I will win this debate. And then I went to my mom, and I said, Mom, I'm just one person, what can I do? And she said, there was one person who thought of treating the needy. And because she thought, and she treated a dog, and the idea grew, she was called Lady with the Lamp, Florence Nightingale. There were two people who thought of distributing blood across the world, and the idea grew to Red Cross Society. And you were just one person. All right, I had decided I wasn't getting any help from anyone. So off I went, I wrote down my speech. The next day I went and delivered the best debate of my life, and I won! And the first person who stepped up on that stage and hugged me and congratulated me was Dr. Vibha Shetty. And she said, how do you feel? Great! Would you have felt the same thing had I helped you? And that day, I learned my second most important lesson. Be true. Be true to yourself. Be different, be true. I went to do my post-graduation, and we had a conference, and I had to present a research paper. While my batchmates were researching about the latest inventions, stem cell therapy, gene pool therapy, I was doing my research on the effect of tea on oral health. Tea and dental health? Do you even think this will work? Hindsight, we say 100%. I walked out with the YP Goglani National Award for Research during that conference. Be different, be true to yourself. Dr. Vibha Shetty took I was like, oh my God. There were people three times my age, three times my weight, and many times my speaking experience. They were fantastic. And I said, someday I'm going to be able to speak like these people. And I promised that to myself. Neither Dr. Bikashiti nor I could think the kind of change that little action of taking me to that club would bring. I started training. I started public speaking. Year after year, week after week, month after month, I was on stage competing with some of the best minds in our country and beyond. That one year, I had written the best speech of my life. And you know, when you have the best speech and you have a speaking competition and you know you're going to win it, the best speech, the best delivery, I went on stage, I started speaking, 45 seconds, the audience was mesmerized. 45 seconds into the speech, my collar mic fell down. Ouch. I had a choice. I could either pick up the mic, put it back and continue speaking, which would look awkward, or I could let it be and continue as if nothing had happened. I chose the latter. An audience of 350 people. I lost out on about 75% of the audience. And you know, when they don't hear you, you don't win. So I came back, I sat down, dejected, in despair. And my mentor walked up to me. Now my mentor is this short, bald man, let's just call him Yoda. Not because he looks like Yoda, but because he's a powerhouse of knowledge and wisdom. And he said, let's have a cup of tea. So he took me to the restaurant, and he sat down, and I started cribbing and ranting. I lost. It's not fair. Life is not fair. I had the best speech. He smiled and said, I know. And my mic fell down. He's like, so? So I failed. I didn't get the prize. He said, so? So I ended up looking like a monkey in front of 350 people with a tail. And he said, so? Will you let a failure define you? And that day I learned my third most important lesson. Life is not about what happens to you. Life is about what you do with what happens to you. We all make mistakes. But just because we make a mistake doesn't mean we are a mistake. What defines you? I opened a training company. I successfully joined a college and taught students communication and business. Business and managerial communication at an MBA institute in Delhi from a dental background. It was an achievement in itself. I was also the chief trainer for the youth leadership program for American Embassy across India 3 years in a row. A few months ago, I attended a MasterChef cooking course by MasterChef Kunal Kapoor. He stepped up. Now there is this weird thing about me. You know, there are people when you tell them to come at 7 and they come at 8, they're always late. I am just the opposite. You ask me to come at 7, I'll be there by 6 or 5:30. And if it's the morning, I'm the one who gets the doors open. So I was there sitting early, sipping my tea, and he came in to check the mics, and he went, ah! What just happened? Oh, the mic's not working right. Okay, so the audiovisual team and Kunal Kapoor were fiddling with the mic, trying to adjust it, just before his vocation, live. And he went, bip, bip! No, I'm bip, bip! For the next 10 minutes, they fought with the mic. And my expression had gone from a smile to an outright laugh. And he said, "At least someone finds this funny. You find it funny, don't you?" And I said, "Yes. Does it define how well you cook?" Lesson three, what defines you? I walked out that day having tasted and learned some of the best snacks that I know today. How many of you have heard? A lot can happen over tea. Trust me, after spending weeks, months, years in cafes, I'm some sort of an authority when I tell you this. Nothing ever happens over a cup of tea or coffee unless you make it happen. Share a bit of yourself with someone. Share your story. Or share your time. Find your incredible. And if it changes you, let it. Because sometimes we are the tea, and sometimes we are the water. Be different. Be true. Find what defines you. Dare to be your uniquely you. Everything that I learned in life, I learned it